हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू दिस सेशन ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स एंड डिज़ाइन। माई सेल्फ विमल सलोत फ्रॉम एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस मेथड्स टू ड्रॉ द एलिप्स, दैट इज आर्क ऑफ सर्कल मेथड एंड फोर सेंटर मेथड। सो बिफोर दैट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड सम टर्मिनोलॉजी रिलेटेड टू एलिप्स। वी नो दैट एवरी एलिप्स has two axes, major axis and minor axis. So here one O point is considered as center point and two axes are taken, AB and CD, as the major and minor axis of the given ellipse. So here AB is the major axis and CD is the minor axis, and O point is the point where both of the axes are intersecting with each other. F1 and F2 are the two focus points for the given ellipse. On this ellipse, let us consider two points P and Q. So the relation, that is distance of P point from the focus F point and distance of P from the focus F2, if you take summation of both of this distance, that is PF1 plus PF2, is equal to major axis. Or if we consider Q point on the ellipse, then also QF1 plus QF2, that would be also major axis. Similarly, C point is also on the ellipse, so CF1 plus CF2, that should be also equal to major axis. That is the relation which is required to be remembered. Now, CF1 plus CF2, that is equal to AB, as we have discussed here. Then CF1 is equal to CF2. So we can say that either CF1 or CF2 is equal to half of the major axis. So these are the some relations or equations which are required to remember. Sometimes it happens that some of the data are given and some data need to be found out. Here it is a distance PF1, PF2, this distance QF1, QF2, and CF1 and CF2. Now let's see arc of circle method to draw the ellipse. Major and minor axes of the ellipse are 120 mm and 80 mm long. Draw the ellipse by arc of circle method. Major axis is 120, minor axis is 80 mm, and we have to use arc of circle method to draw the ellipse. So first draw the major axis AB taking 120 mm dimension. From the midpoint of this AB, draw minor axis, that is 80 mm, but from this midpoint, above and below distance is to be taken as 40 mm. So CD is total length of minor axis, that is 80 mm. O point is the intersecting point. So if you consider OC, then OC is equal to OD, that is equal to 40. So total CD is equal to 80 mm. Now for arc of circle method, it is necessary to locate focus point. We know that CF1 is equal to CF2, that is equal to half of major axis. So we have to take compass size equal to half of major axis. Half of major axis, it means half of 120 mm. So take compass size equal to 60 mm, keep C point at the center point and draw an arc. So here we will get the even intersecting point, that is focus F1. Here also draw the intersecting arc, that is another intersecting point, that is another focus. F1 and F2 are the two focus points. Now AB is major axis, CD is minor axis, F1 and F2 are the focus points. Consider the distance F1O. This distance we have to consider, and that distance is to be divided into numbers of equal parts. Here we are dividing it into four numbers of equal parts. it is not necessary that all the divisions would have the exactly equal dimension, but somewhat they should be equal. If there is some minor difference between the dimensions of the division, then it is okay. So here we have divided this epsilon into 5 divisions. Now we have to locate the points to draw the ellipse, and for that, in first step, take compass size equal to A1. A1 means distance from A to division number 1. Keep F1 point as center point. Here F1 point is center point, and draw an arc. You have to draw an arc over here on this side. Then take compass size equal to B1. B1 means distance from B point to division number 1. Keep F2 as center point and draw an intersecting arc over here. So this intersecting point is the required point. Then next step, compass size equal to A2, distance from A to division number 2, that is compass size. Keep F1 at the center and draw an arc over here. Then change compass size, take compass size equal to B2, keep F2 at the center point and draw an intersecting arc over here. That is our next point for the ellipse. Then compass size equal to A3, keep F1 at the center point and draw an arc over here. Then change compass size, take it is equal to B3, keep F2 at the center and draw an intersecting arc. And then take compass size equal to A4, draw an arc over here. Then change compass size, take it as B4, keep F2 as center point, draw an intersecting arc. So these all intersecting points are the required points for the ellipse. Mark them as P1, P2, P3, P4, and join all these points with smooth gradient curve. Same procedure we have to draw for this next quarter part, and join all the points, intersecting points, with smooth gradient arc. Similar procedure we have to repeat for the remaining quarter part and join all these points with smooth gradient curve. Write down the dimensions, major axis 120 and minor axis 80 mm, half of minor axis OC equal to 40 mm, or you can also write down this total dimension CD equal to 80 mm. So what is the procedure to draw the ellipse by arc of circle method? Now, next part of the question, if it is asked, draw tangent and normal at any point on the curve. So, after preparing ellipse, we have to draw tangent and normal at any point on the curve. So, randomly, first select a point on the curve. Here, this point is selected on the curve. So, from this point, we have to draw tangent and normal. Let us take this selected point as Q point. Join this Q point with the focus F1 and F2. Join Q and F1, also join Q and F2. So here one angle is prepared, F1, Q, F2. We have to draw the bisector of this angle. Bisector of this angle is actually normal at given point A. So draw the bisector, and this line is bisecting line, so it is normal at given point Q. And normal and tangent are always perpendicular to each other. So from Q point on this line, draw a line at an angle of 90 degrees, so it is tangent, and bisector is the normal. Next method is four center method. Draw a rhombus of 90 mm and 60 mm long diagonal. Draw an ellipse in it. as it is a four center method, we are going to use four centers in both the ellipse, and it can be inscribed inside a rhombus. So here rhombus size is given as 90 by 60 mm. So actually these are the diagonals, it's not the size of the rhombus, but these are the square rhombus of 90 mm, 60 mm long diagonals. So these are the actually diagonal size 90 and 60. So we are taking PR as 90 and QS as 60 mm. So these are the two diagonals, PR and SQ. Now mark midpoint of all the sides of this rhombus as it is shown here, and let us take all these midpoints as A, B, C and D. So these are the center points for the rhombus, for the sides of the rhombus. Now we have two diagonals PQ, we have two diagonals PR and QS, and midpoints of all these sides ABCD. Actually Q and S are the two center points. Two points of shorter diagonal are two center points. So consider this point Q of shorter diagonal and join it with A point, then consider S, join also with B point, then consider S point, second point of the shorter diagonal, join it with B and join it with C point. So here we are getting intersecting point with longer diagonal. So these intersecting points are actually another two center points required to draw the ellipse. Here all the centers are marked as 1, so it is center point number 1, then 2, so 1 and 2 are the actually two points of the shorter diagonal, then 3 and 4 are the intersecting points which are obtained here. Now keep one number as center and take compass size equal to 1A and draw an arc, then take two number as center, compass size equal to 2C and draw an arc. Then keep 3 as the center point, take compass size 3A or 3D, both will be equal. Keep 3 as the center and draw an arc. Then keep 4 as the center, take compass size equal to 4B or 4C, both will be equal. So it is the 4, keep 4 as the center and draw an arc. So you can see it is a ellipse inside the rhombus. So for that we should have the diagonal size of the rhombus or the side size of the rhombus. It is also known as four center method to draw the ellipse. Write down the dimension, longer diagonal 90 mm and the shorter diagonal is 60, half of shorter is 30 mm. Thank you very much.